Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to Physics Department, Bagh School. Students will continue with the past purpose practice, and this is lecture number 9. And in lecture number 9, we are going to discuss next two MCQs. MCQ number 21, which statement about electromagnetic waves in a vacuum is correct? Basically, what has been demanded from us that we have to correct, we have to select one of the correct options, and according to what guiding principle we have to select, that what is true about electromagnetic waves in a vacuum. Option A, amplitude is inversely proportional to the velocity. No, this is a non-valid relationship, so option A is not correct. Option B, frequency is inversely proportional to wavelength. Yes, frequency is inversely proportional to wavelength by equation V is equal to F into lambda, where frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional to each other. In option C, it has been stated intensity is proportional to amplitude. No, intensity is proportional to the square of the amplitude. And option D, velocity is proportional to wavelength. In a vacuum, it's this relationship doesn't hold, so we are only left with the correct option, that is option B. Moving on to the next question, MCQ number 22. A transverse wave travels along a rope. The graph shows the variation of the displacement of the particles in the rope with distance along it at a particular instant. Students, we have been given the graph, and this is a displacement distance graph. We have been given the values of distance, and we have been shown the direction of the travel of wave. And what we have to do, the question further states, at which distance along the rope do the particles have maximum upwards velocity? Okay, to determine maximum upwards velocity, students, what we have to do, we have to move against the direction of the travel of the wave. It means we have to move from this point towards this point. If we move from this point towards this point, this will be downwards motion, this will be downwards motion, this will be rest motion, this will be upward motion, this will be rest motion, this will be downward, this will be downward, this will be downward, this will be rest position or rest state of rest. This is upwards motion, this is upwards motion, this is upwards motion, and again at this point it is rest. Okay, to determine the maximum velocity, if we determine the gradient of displacement time graph, the gradient of displacement time graph gives us the value of velocity. So it means that where the gradient is going to be maximum, velocity is going to be maximum. This is the this is one of the point, and the second condition is that the velocity should be acting upwards. These are the two guiding principles according to which we have to select the correct option. Okay, if we decide that these are the two particles where it is moving, these are the two points where it is moving upwards, okay, and this is 2.5 and this is 0.5, velocity is maximum at this point and this point, but 2.5 is not in the option, it is only 0.5 in the option, so option A is correct. Students, if you have any problem, you can contact me. Allah Hafiz.